Hey guys, welcome back on my YouTube channel. This is the initialization part 2. In the part 1, we have seen how we can define the init, why we need to use and where we have to use. Okay guys, so we have seen some parameterized initializers and some default initializers, delegation. Okay, in this video I'm gonna talk about the designated initializers and the convenience initializers. And guys, there may be a chance in interview room the interviewer may ask what is the difference between designated initializers and the convenience initializers. So stay tuned to understand about this concept, okay, so that you can tell in the interview room. Okay, so guys, before understanding the designated initializers and convenience initializers, we need to understand the initializers within inheritance concept. Okay, so let's jump on the Xcode and let's understand. So guys, let's say we have a class parent, and this parent class having init with two parameters. Let's say we have one parameter is a and another one is b. Okay, so this is the init, and we are not defining the body here. Actually, we don't want to pass any statement because this is just a demonstration. Okay, I'm not going to put any code here, and there is a class child that is inherited from our parent. Okay, so what happens guys if I try to create instance of child? Okay, so see what happens. Means I'm not defining any init for child, but it is asking to pass the parameters here. Why guys, do you know why it is asking? Because you have defined init into parent class. Are you getting my point? So this parent class init is automatically inherited into child class. That's why it is asking to pass the parameters here. Are you getting my point? Are you getting? So this is the scenario which going to be happen. So let's say we are defining the same init here also. Okay, the same init here also, and we are actually overriding, right? So override, and we are overriding the above init, and this overrided init I want to call the parent class init. Are you getting my point? And whatever the a's value is coming here, I want to pass the okay. Now the problem is what guys, my problem is what, I don't want to pass two parameters for this child. I want to pass only single parameter, but problem is what guys, I have overrided the init method and we are demanding for two values. Okay, so if I create the instance of this child class, then it will ask for two parameters. Okay, so instead of passing these two parameters, what we can do here, we can define one init with convenience keyword. Okay, and we can pass a single parameter. Okay, and within this parameter, what we can do, we can call the init of the same class. Are you getting my point? So let me remove this, and we can pass the a's value here, and we can pass the b's value as 0. Are you getting my point? So the a's value will be defined by user, but the b's value we have given as 0. Are you getting my point? So this is the thing which I'm going to do here. Okay, so let me put the self also here, and what is the problem here? Okay, so we need to define the parameter names also. Okay, parameter names. Now guys, I can do what guys, now I can call the child class constructor, and I can pass only a single value, okay guys, instead of two values, as you can see guys. Now let's run it. So guys, I think this is successfully run. Now let's print obj dot a, and I think a is not a variable, na, right? So let me remove this statement actually. So guys, as you can see, this is what your convenience init, and this init is known as designated init. Okay, so this is designated init, this is also, but this is a convenience init. So if your init is calling another init that is available in the same class or structure, then In that case, this init is known as convenience init. Are you getting my point? So there is one more example. I think the same example I have wrote here also. Okay, I hope clarity about it. Now guys, the next thing is what required initializers. Okay, so if you want to make a initializer as required, means that should be called while instantiating your class. Okay, let's say we have a class. Okay, so let's say we have this init. Okay, let me define one more init here. Init. Okay, and I am doing what, guys? I am printing one statement here. Okay, required init is here. Okay, and I am defining this init as required. Okay, so now guys, see what happens. I am trying to run, but it is giving me one error. That is what? Required initializer must be provided by subclass. Are you getting my point? So means if you define the init as required, then in the subclass the implementation should be there. Are you getting my point? Means this initializer should also available here. Okay, so let's provide the initializer here. So as you can see, guys, I have defined the initializer here. Okay, so I have implemented here. Now it will not show any error, and let's run it. Okay, so it is successfully run. And so guys, if I don't want to pass any value, then I can create the what happens. Okay, so I have thrown a fatal error. Okay, so let me print one statement here. Required sub class init is here. Okay, and we need to call what, guys? Our super class init also, right? So let me run it. So guys, as you can see, it is successfully called. So if I defined a init as required in the parent, then you should have to provide the implementation in child also for that init. Are you getting my point? I hope you have clarity about it. So guys, you can create the instance like this also. Okay, okay, fine. So let me pass the label name. Okay, so guys, this is successfully done. So I hope now you have clear clarity about the required initializers, and you have clear clarity about our designated and convenience initializers. Okay guys, so don't be confused, and this is not actually you are going to use in your projects most of the times. Okay, so don't worry about it, and I will see you in the next video. Guys, if you like the video, then hit the like button and share with your friends. If you are having any issue related to this video, you can comment in the comment section. I will see you in the next video with the new topic.